And so you might have thought that we kind of planned this a little bit, but you just saw Constance and Jasmine go over some of the projects and give you project updates. What I'm gonna do is show you a little bit of the sausage making. That was the end product. All of these beautiful projects that have reached incubation or reached graduation or have come into the sandbox. But how does all of that machinery work? That's what I'm gonna share with you today. So for starters, let's go back and think about the CNCF mission. It is to make cloud-native computing ubiquitous. Why? Well, because there's a huge amount of value in that. There's customer value for that. Now, the Technical Oversight Committee plays a role in fulfilling that mission by guiding the technical decisions that serve it. So those technical decisions are all about those incubating projects, those graduated projects, the sandbox projects, and so on. So on behalf of our chair, Liz Rice, and the entire TOC, I also want to welcome, echo everybody else's welcome to all of you here in Los Angeles, as well as those of you that are on board. So here's the TOC members. Now, what KubeCon would be complete if we didn't show the CNCF landscape? And yeah, you can kind of chuckle a little bit. I think when I look at it, of course, it's an eye chart, and it's, yeah, intended to be so in some ways. But you know, if you look in that upper right-hand corner, the second box down, there's a whole bunch of pinheads in there. So that's kind of cheating. It's like there's a whole landscape within a landscape. But I promise you, one of the things that I want to do is I want to help you understand, and I'll show how the Technical Oversight Committee, as well as the tags, and I'll talk more about what those are, help us keep this all under control. So I hope to give you a little bit of a decoder ring to the cloud-native landscape. Now, you'll notice that there's a whole bunch of little teeny tiny boxes, and you'll notice that there's some boxes that are slightly larger when you look at that screen. Well, those slightly larger boxes are all the ones that are incubating projects and graduated projects. And I'm gonna talk a little bit more about that for a moment. But before I get there, I wanna point out that the landscape itself is open source. Just like everything else in the CNCF and the Linux Foundation, we are grounded in open source. So if you want to see something added to the landscape, that's an open source. It's a pull request against a repository. So even the landscape itself is open source. Now, of course, as a part of open source, we have governance and curation. So let me talk a little bit more about that governance and curation that you see represented with the slightly larger boxes. You've already heard reference to this, which is the crossing the chasm. Now, I've mentioned three different things already: sandbox projects, incubating projects, and graduated projects. The sandbox projects are the long tail on the left-hand side of this bell curve. Those are the things that are really the early, early days. We're doing a lot of experimenting, and the CNCF gives you an opportunity, a place to do that experimentation in a highly collaborative and very diverse environment. And the TOC does vote on the addition of sandbox projects into the CNCF. Then, when we get to the point where it's starting to prove itself out, it's still not in the majority, but it's starting to show a great deal of promise, and we want to bring it to the next level, that's when projects can apply for incubation. And then eventually, once they've crossed the chasm, and we know not everything crosses the chasm, but once they have, and they've achieved a great deal of adoption, where it's really quite obvious that this is something that is of value to the entire community, that's when a project reaches graduation. Now, the Technical Oversight Committee for years has had the responsibility of running this process. And back in circa 2018, when the landscape looked like this, the TOC could do that. Those dozen people or so could manage the level of work and complexity that was in this chart. But I'll remind you, it doesn't look like that anymore. So how on earth can we scale to do that governance process when the landscape has gotten that large and complex? Enter the technical advisory groups. You might know them from their previous name, which was special interest groups. That's what we used to call them. This year, we changed the name to technical advisory group for really two reasons. One, which is a little bit more kind of pragmatic, in that the Kubernetes project also had the notion of special interest groups. And there would sometimes be confusion between the special interest groups of the CNCF and those of the Kubernetes project. So that was part of the reason. But this name, technical advisory group, really shows that these tags are an extension of the charter of the technical oversight committee. They really are the technical advisory groups that help the whole system run. Now, I'm going to talk about each of those as we go along, but let's talk about what tags do. First of all, they have a charter. They have a number of projects that they overlook, and you'll see that there's project categories that they overlook, that they take care of as they go along. They themselves have a governance process, and they have leaders, and I'm going to introduce you to all of those as we go along. And they do a lot of the heavy lifting. They do a lot of the technical due diligence and a lot of the work, and they provide a forum for various projects and problems to be brought for being addressed within the CNCF community. So, and they play a huge role. This is kind of the overall schematic of the way that projects go from sandbox to incubation to graduation. And I want to point out the amount of work that they do, particularly where you see that dark, dark bar right in the middle. There's a very significant barrier, and there's a lot of the work that goes into bringing these projects that you just saw updates on, bringing those projects to those levels. So, before we jump into the details of each, you know, some of the high-level details of each of the tags, I want to come back to the landscape. This is only a portion of the landscape, and this is the portion of the landscape that really has all of those projects that we've been talking about. Now, I want to overlay the tags on top of this. Let's start with runtime. So the runtime tag, if you will, is all about compute, and it takes care of these portions of the landscape. Then we have the storage tag, which takes care of another portion of the landscape. We have networking, so that's compute, storage, and networking. Then, of course, I know I probably should have started here, but we've got security. Then we've got all of the things that are running on top of this cloud-native platform and this cloud-native ecosystem. That's the app delivery tag. And finally, we've got the observability tag. So now let me tell you a little bit about each one of those. We'll start again in the order that I just did, which is tag runtime. Tag runtime, of course, is where you'll notice if you go back and look at what I just showed you, Kubernetes itself kind of lives under that umbrella. But then there's other projects like Cryo and those projects that are all about workloads. You can see that workloads is highlighted on this particular slide. Also, it's not just the workloads that come and go and we scale and we have autoscalers for, but it's also those batch workloads. So it's anything that has to do with making sure that workloads are running efficiently. The other thing I want to draw your attention to is the second bullet there where it says, we reach out. They proactively will reach out, and the tags do this, and look at projects and say, hey, this is a project that's really relevant to this space. So they are really an outreach arm into the community. Now, moving on to storage, I want to highlight a couple of things on this slide. You'll notice here that there's a couple of different buckets of leadership within the tag. There's the co-chairs, and then there's also tech leads. So hint, hint, these are opportunities for you to play a leadership role within the CNCF, and they're always looking for help. Now, in addition to these leadership roles, there are armies, usually small armies, but there are whole groups of people that support the work of these tags. And so you can see here that I am, of course, not being very veiled on an invitation for you to join these tags. They're always looking for help to do a lot of the work that we're talking about here. Now, I want to point out a couple of things here that you'll also notice that there's mention of a white paper. So almost every one of the tags is working on some type of white papers that even if you cannot volunteer, they are building the resources that you're going to be able to use to make a cloud-native journey in your organizations very successful. Take a look at those white papers. You'll also notice that it lists a number of projects that they brought into incubation stages, and I already mentioned those. Now, Tag Network, of course, is dealing with all things networking, and they highlighted here that one of the areas that they're putting a lot of emphasis is on service mesh. Now, one of the really cool things that I want to draw your attention to here is, first of all, they're looking at conformance, performance, and patterns, so good usage patterns. But if we take a look at the concept of conformance, the whole point here is that there's not a single service mesh. There's a number of different open source projects, which is a sign of a really strong open source ecosystem, that it's not dominated by a single project. At the CNCF, we have never wanted to be kingmakers. We've never wanted to be the organization that selected a project and put them on a pedestal. Instead, we take approaches like this where we say, okay, there's multiple projects, they each have their strengths. How do we make sure that our community can use them without confusion, and conformance can help? Now, so that's compute, storage, and networking. On security, of course, you can see I'm going to draw your attention to words like protect and help. You'll see that the second bullet there is around security reviews. So the security tag helps a great deal as these projects move into incubation and then move on into graduation. We want to ensure that those are secure so that you as a user community can embrace those and have a great deal of confidence that you're using secure solutions. So the security tag plays a significant role in that as well. Now, the next one that I want to talk, so now we've just talked about the platform, which is compute, storage, networking, and the security around that. Now, why are we building these platforms? Why are we setting them up? Well, it's because we want to run workloads. We want to run applications on those. And so we have a tag which is all about the technology that is helping you run those applications, keep them running, and have them be resilient in those environments. They've done cool projects, like there's the Potato Head project, which is a demo application that has a whole bunch of different technologies wrapped around it to show you how you can not only write that application, but keep it running securely and safely in production. It's also been the place where a lot of working groups have been created, like the GitOps working group, which has generated the Open GitOps project. That's a sandbox project. And then you can see that there's a lot of work going on around chaos and chaos engineering, which of course is all about keeping your workloads running well. And finally, we have the tag observability. So years ago, when I was working on Cloud Foundry at Pivotal, one of the very first customers that I interacted with, every time I visited them every 2 weeks, they would say, Cornelia, you're giving me a sports car, but I don't have the dashboards to know how well it's running. This is the team that's all about those dashboards and making sure that the observability tools are there that are helping you gain insight into the way that your cloud-native deployments are working. And they have, one of the things that they have done is they've done quite a number. You heard OpenTelemetry referred to. They've also done some other very, very significant deep dives into the technical due diligence around these projects as they've moved into incubation. Now, those are all of the tags that are involved in these projects. And again, I'll remind you that it's the incubating projects that we just saw some updates on, as well as the graduated projects. Now, for those of you keeping count, you might notice that there's one additional tag that I haven't mentioned. And that tag is the contributor strategy. Yes, indeed. Now, Paris, Carolyn, Stephen, and Josh are among, and the entire tag are among, you would not find more helpful and empathetic people within the Cloud Native Computing Foundation. And that's saying a lot, because as a whole, we're a very inclusive and open and helpful organization. These folks are really at the tip top. And they are all about making you successful as users. It's not the user community, but they do so by supporting every one of the other tags in making sure that they can invite contributors and make those contributor experiences very positive. So they are, if you will, the lifeblood of all the other tags, and by extension, the TOC. So once again, I just want to emphasize your invitation to come and get involved, and these folks are going to help you get involved, and get involved in all of the tags. And then the final thing that I want to leave you with is, speaking of getting involved, we have an upcoming election for the Technical Oversight Committee itself. So if you are somebody who is really entrenched in the technology, remember this is a technical position, you are somebody who wants to help the CNCF, and you have the time to be on the Technical Oversight Committee, please nominate yourself. If you know somebody who falls into that category, nominate them, speak with them first, but please nominate them. Nominations are due at the beginning of December, and we'll be expanding, adding to the TOC. And with that, I thank you for your attention, and I wish you a great conference. Have a good day.